Accidental Presidents, Eight Men Who Changed America. Hardcover, April 9, 2019, by Jared Cohen, author. The strength and prestige of the American presidency has waxed and waned since George Washington. Accidental Presidents looks at eight men who came to the office without being elected. It demonstrates how the character of the man in that powerful seat affects the nation and world. Eight men have succeeded to the presidency when the incumbent died in office. In one way or another, they vastly changed our history. Only Theodore Roosevelt would have been elected in his own right. Only T.R. Truman, Coolidge, and LBJ were re-elected. John Tyler succeeded William Henry Harrison, who died 30 days into his term. He was kicked out of his party and became the first president threatened with impeachment. Millard Fillmore succeeded esteemed General Zachary Taylor. He immediately sacked the entire cabinet and delayed an inevitable civil war by standing with Henry Clay's Compromise of 1850. Andrew Johnson, who succeeded our greatest president, sided with remnants of the Confederacy in Reconstruction. Chester Arthur, the embodiment of the spoils system, was so reviled as James Garfield's successor that he had to defend himself against plotting Garfield's assassination, but he reformed the civil service. Theodore Roosevelt broke up the trusts. Calvin Coolidge silently cooled down the Harding scandals and preserved the White House for the Republican Herbert Hoover in the Great Depression. Truman surprised everybody when he succeeded the great FDR and proved an able and accomplished president. Lyndon B. Johnson was named to deliver Texas electorally. He led the nation forward on civil rights but failed on Vietnam. Accidental Presidents adds immeasurably to our understanding of the power and limits of the American presidency in critical times. 261 editorial reviews. What a delightful book and brilliant concept. Jared Cohen treats us to some of the most colorful and momentous episodes in our history when we unexpectedly got a new president. He reveals the historic importance of some lesser-known leaders, such as John Tyler and Millard Fillmore, and highlights the greatness of Teddy Roosevelt, Harry Truman, and Lyndon Johnson. Through their fascinating tales, we learn why America is such a resilient nation and our Constitution a living document. Lessons very powerful for today. Walter Isaacson. Number 1 New York Times best-selling author of Leonardo da Vinci. Fascinating, compelling, and often alarming. With astonishing story after story, Jared Cohen chronicles the whole pageant of the unsteady, the unready, and the unexpectedly capable. Nearly 10% of our presidents succeeded because of the deaths of those who chose them, mostly out of political expediency to be forgotten number twos. Will we luck out in the future with a surprising Harry Truman or with a wrecker like Andrew Johnson? In God We Trust. But read Jared Cohen, Sidney Blumenthal, author of A Self-Made Man and Wrestling with His Angels. Thanks to Jared Cohen, the stories of eight accidental presidents are now all in one grand place. Cohen deserves a medal for performing this public service. Patricia O'Toole, author of The Moralist, Woodrow Wilson and the World He Made. History is the most contingent of enterprises. And little has proven more contingent than the nature of the American presidency. In this eloquent and often surprising book, Jared Cohen explores how fate has shaped the office and all of us. In an age marked by widespread concerns about the character of the person who reaches the pinnacle, by whatever means, Cohen's study is illuminating and resonant. John Meacham. Number 1 New York Times best-selling author of The Soul of America, The Battle for Our Better Angels. Pleasant reading for politics junkies, especially those keen on reading the political winds, Kirkus Reviews. Illuminating, a genuinely interesting history on a topic that has never been addressed in this depth book list, colorful, clear and engaging, confidently told, Publishers Weekly. One of the many insights to be found in Accidental Presidents is that history unfolds in death as well as in life, The Wall Street Journal. About the author, Jared Cohen is the founder and CEO of Jigsaw at Alphabet Inc. He also serves as an adjunct senior fellow at the Council on Foreign Relations. Previously, he ran Google Ideas at Google Inc. and served as chief advisor to Google executive chairman Eric Schmidt. From 2006 to 2010, he served as a member of the Secretary of State's policy planning staff and as a close advisor to Condoleezza Rice and Hillary Clinton. He is the New York Times best-selling author of Accidental Presidents, The New Digital Age, Children of Jihad, and 100 Days of Silence, America and the Rwanda Genocide. He lives in New York with his wife and two daughters. He also serves as an adjunct senior fellow at the Council on Foreign Relations. Prior to Alphabet, he was Google's first director of ideas and chief advisor to Google's executive chairman Eric Schmidt. From 2006 to 2010, he served as a member of the Secretary of State's policy planning staff and as a close advisor to both Condoleezza Rice and Hillary Clinton. Cohen is the New York Times best-selling author of four books, including Children of Jihad, 100 Days of Silence, America and the Rwanda Genocide, and The New Digital Age, Transforming Nations, Business, and Our Lives, which he co-authored with Eric Schmidt. His new book, The Accidental Presidents, examines the eight instances in American history when a president has died in office. His writing has appeared in the New York Times, Wall Street Journal, Foreign Affairs, LA Times, Washington Post, Time Magazine, and Foreign Policy. He has been named to the Time 100 list, Foreign Policy's Top 100 Global Thinkers, and Vanity Fair's Next Establishment. Cohen serves on several advisory boards, including Allianz, Stanford University's Freeman Spogli Institute, Rivet Ventures, Fluid Market, ASAPP, and NCTC. He is a member of Genext and a young global leader at the World Economic Forum. Cohen received his BA from Stanford University and his MPhil in International Relations from the University of Oxford, where he studied as a Rhodes Scholar. He speaks fluent Swahili. Reviews. Required reading. Accidental Presidents reminds me why it's so important to dive deep into our history. As an educator, the stories, critical and urgent lessons in civics, and thoughtful analysis make this book an easy page-turner. It was easy to navigate key moments in our common history: the war with Mexico, the Compromise of 1850, Reconstruction, machine politics of the 1880s, the rise of Teddy Roosevelt, the corruption of the Harding years, World War II, civil rights, and Vietnam. This is more than just a book about people who were never supposed to be president. The book is a brilliant refresher course in American history that should be required reading. Cohen does an impressive job in both teaching history and making it interesting. He finds the right balance between history and interpretation, the counterfactual lessons and what-ifs really come out in this riveting book. Page-turner, important, and great gift for friends. This book is awesome. Amazing how much we take for granted with our history. It's fun, interesting, surprising, incredible. Cohen has something for everyone, keeping you engaged throughout. Each chapter is in a sense its own little novella. Fascinating political maneuvering, high-stakes transfers of power, leadership lessons, funny stories of big personalities from our past. Buy one for yourself and everyone else you know. You and them will be better for it. You must read this book. This book is a necessary read, especially in today's world, with such a focus on our state of government, as well as the trend of making history popular again. Hello, Hamilton. This blends all of it perfectly. By understanding the eight times history has changed by the beat of a heart, we know we can always bounce back from unexpected change in circumstance. Learn so much and could not put it down. A must read. Wonderful book. You will find this book surprisingly gripping, thoughtful, and funny. The stories are remarkable and edifying, while also being somehow poignant for today. Well worth it. Riveting and readable. This book is fascinating. The author's approach gives readers the opportunity to consider history differently than it is typically learned. I appreciate the balance of creativity and skilled research. As a history buff, I had genuine fun reading this book, particularly like the Harding, Coolidge section. Fans of history, politics, and lessons in leadership must read this book. He is back. Jared Cohen tells the story of the 8 times in history a president has died in office and how these abrupt transitions of power changed the course of history. Accidental presidents and quirks of history. A fascinating and readable history of the presidents who weren't supposed to be. With the exception of Teddy Roosevelt, they were not apt to be elected president in their own right, and only 2 of the accidental presidents, T.R. and Harry Truman, would become great presidents. The book tells us about a number of unremarkable presidents we might not otherwise have met, like John Tyler, Millard Fillmore, Chester Alan Arthur, or Calvin Coolidge. So the book does take up some out-of-the-way biographies. We also learn about some fortuitous accidents in the presidency. The intra-GOP intrigue between Garfield's and Arthur's factions and Chet Arthur's highly checkered career before and during his time as VP, or the astonishing corruption of Harding's administration. Warren G. Harding's death probably spared them a terrible culpability for the antics of his cronies and his mistresses. Harry Truman became FDR's VP in the most casual and chancy way during the 1944 convention. LBJ was in severe trouble over the Bobby Baker corruption scandal when JFK was shot, shifting the spotlight away. The book also traces the history of presidential succession and its uncertainties up till LBJ's time, when the 25th Amendment clarified it. The original Constitution was not clear about that, and when William Henry Harrison, the first president to die in office, did so 1 month into his term in 1841. What was Vice President John Tyler to be? Acting president? President? Something or someone else? And with the vice presidency vacated by the successor, what then? One fascinating aspect of this book is that it tells how close several accidental presidents came to dying accidentally themselves in their accidental first term with no VP in place. John Tyler, almost killed in an explosion on a U.S. Navy vessel. Andrew Johnson, almost assassinated along with Lincoln, almost died of illness in his first weeks as president. Impeached and almost removed from office. Chester Arthur, terminally ill in his final year. Theodore Roosevelt, almost killed in a 1904 streetcar crash. LBJ, a known history of heart trouble. It's a quirky set of histories, but as a review of presidential succession, it's a fine summary, and it's an interesting new contribution to the history of the U.S. presidency. Strongly recommend The Unexpected Presidents. This is one of the best books I've read in a long time. History buffs will thoroughly enjoy the story of the 8 vice presidents who became president upon the current president dying. Readers will be familiar with Roosevelt and Truman, of course, but the lesser-known stories of John Tyler and others are truly captivating. 2 of the worst were undoubtedly Andrew Johnson and Warren Harding. The section on the succession clause in the Constitution is also fascinating reading. A fairly long read, but well worth every minute invested reading.